Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I wanted to share with you a few of my favorite things. These are products that I enjoy, and I wanted to share those with you, and possibly you may decide to purchase them and enjoy them also. So anyway, I just have a few things. I try to keep my favorites around 5 or 6 items. That way I'm just not, man, my hair is frizzy. Anyway, that way I'm not just over saturating you with products. Anyway, so let's get started. So first of all, I want to talk about a beauty tool, a brush that I use pretty much daily. At some point in time, I'm putting my makeup on, and it's this product here, and this is from e.l.f., and it's the e.l.f. Crease Brush, which just looks like that right there. This runs around $3. You can't beat the price, and if you were to take the e.l.f. logo off of here and this was just a brush that was handed to you with no type of branding on it at all, and you go to use it, you would think it would be a high-end brush because it is just really, really good. Especially if you have small hooded eyes, it is just the perfect size for getting into the crease and really doing that that windshield wiper movement to get the product into your crease. And a lot of times when you have a hooded eye, you're actually having to create a new crease. You can't really put it into your original crease because then your eyelid, your hood, it would be lost. So this is just perfect for creating the crease just up a little bit more without getting up into the brow bone area. Because when you have the small hooded eyes like I do, you don't have a whole lot of space to work from lash line to brow line. So you definitely have to have a small brush to work into that area. And I just think this works really, really good. It's not too flimsy, but yet it's not too stiff that you can't work with it. It's just the perfect in between, I guess. Know, kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It was just right. Anyway, I do recommend this. Gosh, if you haven't tried one, definitely. Now, a lot of the e.l.f. products are hit and miss, so when you do come across one or an item from e.l.f. that's good, it's usually like really, really good. So anyway, I do like using that brush and have had it for quite some time. I need to pick up a couple more. A next product that I have been enjoying using, and I got this in I'm pretty sure a kit back during the holidays, and this is from the brand Too Cool for School, and this is the All-in-One Egg Mellow Cream, and it looks like, let's see it now, can't you? I'm going to leave it there for just a few seconds. But anyway, this is just a really good all-in-one cream. I use it during the day for as my last step in my makeup or cosmetic skincare routine before putting my makeup on, and it just has a little pump. First of all, I really appreciate the dispenser on it. This is around $36, so it's not a break the bank type of moisturizer, and it is sold at Sephora. It is a yellow cream, looks like that there. It does have the egg yolk extracts in it. It also has other properties in it that makes it really good for texture and for brightening. So it's gonna exfoliate. You can also use this as like a serum primer. Also as eye cream, a neck cream, a sleeping mask. Gosh, you can use this so many ways, and it just absorbs into the skin just so nice. It's recommended for all skin types. I have really, really dry, mature skin, and for the daytime, I feel like this is a really good moisturizer for me, and like I said, the makeup just lays just really pretty on top of it, so it does help act as a primer. And you can see it there, just a little bit of a glow, and it's not sticky or greasy, and it has a little bit of a scent to it. I can't really way to place it. It's almost like a spice scent to it. But anyway, I just really, really do enjoy using this. So next time you're at Sephora, ask them for a sample of this and see if you like it. So far, I have been very impressed with that line, the Too Cool for School, because I have another product that I'm going to talk about in another favorite that's from that line that I've been using that I really do like. Okay, the next thing I want to talk about is not particularly this product in itself, but the type of product that this is in general. And what I'm talking about is dusting powders or body powders. I don't hardly ever hear anybody talk about them. This is from Clinique and it's the Happy. I seriously doubt that they even sell this anymore. I've had this for a little while, but I have really enjoyed this summer using dusting powders because it's been so hot and humid. And I just really think that it's just a product that years and years and years ago, you know, I can remember growing up, my mother always had dusting powders in the bathroom. And I don't know, I guess they've kind of gone along the wayside. And I will tell you, as a side note, as a caution, you know, definitely you don't want to put dusting powders, body powders, anything with talc in your lady parts that are in the southern region of your body. You know what I'm talking about. You definitely don't want to put powder there. I don't. But I love just putting this all over my chest, underneath the breast, up underneath the armpits. I'll even put some in between my legs on my inner thighs. So when I'm wearing my skorts, my legs aren't rubbing together. It's really good for just as a pick-me-up in later in the afternoon or refreshing if you need to freshen up. Definitely, if you don't have time to go in and take a shower, you can definitely use some body powders. I have this one, and then I have this one here that is not a real Chanel powder. It's supposed to be the Chanel number 5. But I'm positive this is not. I got this at a flea market, but I absolutely love the smell of it. So I'm not mad that it's not a real product, but I love the smell of it. And it's got the big powder poof with it. But these are the two that I've been using a lot. I have a small container of a travel of the shower to shower that I carry in my purse. Because there's times when I get really, really hot and sweaty and I need to be refreshed and cooled off a little bit, and that just really helps. So I am enjoying my dusting powders this summer. Okay, let's go on to another product, and this is from Kate Somerville. Okay, the next product I want to talk to you about is from Kate Somerville, and this was sent to me through Optily, and I've already done a whole video on this, but I have been using it every single night. You can see how much I've used it is like down to here as my face wash, and it's the exfoliate cleanser. It's a daily foaming wash. This runs around $38, which, to be honest, I mean, that's about the normal price of a face wash, one that you're buying at Sephora or at Ulta. This is for helps with exfoliation. I use this after I have cleansed my skin of all makeup. I've gotten all my makeup off and then I use this. This product here also, it just takes a small amount. I mean, probably even less than a pea size amount, because once you put it in your hand and kind of put some water with it, it just really foams up nice. It doesn't irritate the skin. I haven't had any problems with it stinging my eyes. I haven't had any problems with it drying my skin out or making that really tight feeling that you sometimes get after you've washed your face. It has AHAs and natural enzymes in it. It's got pineapple, pumpkin, and papaya fruit enzymes for exfoliation. Gosh, I just really, really do like it, and it has a good smell to it. And like I said, it's very gentle, so I think any type, any skin type could use this. And like I said, I use this every night and have not had any kind of irritation with it whatsoever. Really do appreciate that product and have been enjoying using it. And it works really, really well with the Clarisonic also. Okay, the next product that I have is a little bit off the wall, but it's a favorite, and I'm glad I came across it. I'm glad I bought it, and I have really have been enjoying using it. And it has nothing to do with beauty at all, but it's a home favorite. But anyway, our house that we live in now, the utility room is on the other side of the house. So to get from where the laundry is kept, you have to go through my bedroom, through the living room, through the dining room, through the kitchen, through the office game room, and then to the utility room. So it's pretty good distance to be carrying a basket of clothes. So I was needing a extra basket and was at Target, and I was just going to get just a normal laundry basket. But then I seen this one I'm getting ready to show you, and I thought that will be perfect. So if you have to tote your laundry any distance, maybe you have to go to the laundromat and you need something that's going to help with transporting your laundry back and forth, I recommend this laundry basket that I'm getting to show you. Let's scoot back a little bit so that you can see it in full. But it's this right here, and it is, like I said, I got it at Target. I want to say I paid like $14.99 to $19.99. I couldn't quite remember the price on it, but it's the Home Logic Rolling Hamper. It has wheels on it. Yes. So what you do is the handle pops up and it locks, and then you tilt it and then you can roll it to where you need it. And then when you get to where you're going, you just put the handle back down. And it is perfect. Absolutely perfect. And it holds a lot. I mean, it's not a little basket. It holds a lot. But yet, once you get it full and get it loaded up, you can still roll it very, very easily. And this has just been a lifesaver for me. Plus, the spot that I have where we keep our laundry basket at is in the master bedroom closet, and the space just fits perfectly in that space. So anyway, I recommend, if you need something along those lines, you know, and I'm sure there's other places that you can buy a rolling laundry basket, but that's been very, very handy, very much so. And then I'm going to talk about a couple of movies that we have gone and seen that I thought deserve a mention. One was the movie Dunkirk. A really good movie. I'm not much on war movies, and we had went originally to go see another movie, but we missed the showing time for it, and it was already in 45 minutes into the movie, so I didn't want to, you know, go into a movie that was already partially over. So we went ahead and went seeing Dunkirk, and it was really good. The only thing that I wish they would have done a little bit different with the movie was at the end. I wished when they were rolling the credits that they could have given us some information, you know, what the exact numbers of men that were saved, and maybe what happened to the fighter pilot that was captured at the end. I would kind of like to have known what happened to him, but no, it was a good movie all in all. There wasn't a whole lot of dialogue, so don't go in expecting there to be a whole lot of dialogue, because there wasn't. There's one character, I don't even think he had to learn any lines at all, because I don't think he said anything to come to think of it. But no, it was good. It was a good movie. So even if you're thinking, oh, I don't like war movies, it is worth going and seeing. And the second movie that I highly recommend, I think everybody should go see it, was Atomic Blonde. I love that movie. I want to go see it again, actually. And I can never say her name right. Charlize Theron, is that how you say her name? But anyway, she is such a badass in that movie. I want to be her so bad. I want to be that tall, lean, sophisticated, just badass woman that walks in the room that everybody is just like, she's in charge. But anyway, I really liked that movie, so it was good. And then we just went and seen Dark Tower today. And it was okay, with Matthew McConaughey. I mean, it wasn't just totally awful, but it was okay. So, but definitely Atomic Blonde and Dunkirk, for sure. So anyway, I think that is it for this week's favorites. I hope that you enjoyed, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.